Hi, Professor Vishal Taylor. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Base Mechanical Engineering. In this video, I teach you the work done, velocity triangles, efficiency and maximum efficiency for the perpendicular point. Now we are going through the sequence. First, I teach you the animation of a velocity triangles, how to draw velocity triangles and some tricks for a velocity triangle. Second is also velocity triangle. Third is how to find out the equation of work done, then after how to find out equation of efficiency, and last one and most important, maximum efficiency for a Pelton wheel turbine. So first we starting from the velocity triangle, its animation. So in a Pelton wheel turbine, we already know that is a double hemispherical bucket is used. So first we require to draw the double hemispherical buckets. On this bucket, the water jet is strike in a tangential direction, that means it is come into this horizontal direction. So this part of the bucket is known as the split edge. If you don't know the basic component of a Pelton wheel turbine, then you go to the playlist and also in the description for what that video. So here first I draw this pipe, then the nozzles. From the nozzles, water with velocity V is come and it strike to the bucket. And on the bucket, it is strike on the splitter, and after the striking, jet is moving from this both the spherical bucket, and water is outlet from these parts. So the water coming with the velocity V1 and it strike to plate. So we draw this one line, and its line is indicating the absolute velocity of a jet V1, and its length is A2C. And it is a land A2C, so A2C is indicate the absolute velocity V1. Now after striking, this bucket is start to move with velocity U. This bucket is start to velocity U. So on this line, we are required to draw the velocity U. So velocity of the bucket is always less than the velocity of a jet. And this bucket is moving in a X direction, so on this A2C, some part is we indicate the velocity of a bucket U1 and it's drawn as the A2B. So this A2B line is indicate the velocity of the bucket because it is also in horizontal direction. So we draw on the same line of the V1. Now remaining velocity is the relative velocity. Relative means with respect to the other velocity. So velocity of jet with respect to the bucket. So this is known as the relative velocity, and relative velocity is V1 minus U1. So A to C is V1, A to B is U1. So remaining part is BC. So this BC part is known as the relative velocity VR1. So VR1 is equal to V1 minus U1. Another example is that if you sitting on this bucket and you see the velocity of a jet, then which velocity you see, and it is known as the relative velocity. After that, the water is moving with the surface of this bucket and exit from here at the velocity V2. So for that, here the angle of deflection is given and on the basis of its design. So first we draw the angle of deflection line, and this angle of deflection is denoted as the phi, and this 180 degree line. So 180 minus angle of deflection, then it gives us the beta 2. So the water is coming with the velocity V2 and it's make angle with the X axis. It is known as the alpha 2. So this angle is alpha 2. Now V2 part, it's in certain angle. So it is divided into two part. One is the horizontal, another is the vertical, that we already learned in a cow plate of impact object. If you don't know this derivation, so go to the playlist on impact object and watch the video of moving cow plate water strike at tangential. This is the most important derivation. If you know this that derivation, then you are easily learn all other velocity triangle. So this V2 is divided in two part. One is horizontal. This horizontal part, that is green line, it's indicate the velocity of wall VW2. And this vertical part of the V2 is drawn here. And this vertical part of the V2 is known as the velocity of flow VF2. And horizontal part is known as the VW2. Now, another is the relative velocity. So relative velocity of the bucket in any case is drawn in an angle of deflection line. So this VR2 is drawn in this line. So this line of the orange color is known as a relative velocity line VR2. And this VR2 make an angle with horizontal axis. It is known as the beta 2. Beta 2 means angle between the x-axis and the relative velocity, or it is also known as the blade angle. So this beta 2 is also known blade angle, means this is the blade. So at the exit of the blade there is a certain angle is known as the beta 2. Now again similar relations of the relative velocity equation is applied, that VR2 is V1 minus U1. So similarly here VR2 is equal to relation between the U and V2. So this line is V2. So from V2 to VR2 line is drawn as the velocity of blade line. So it is known as the U2. Okay, so these are the velocity triangles from an impact object. Sorry, velocity triangle for Pelton wheel turbine. Next, we derive the equation of work done for that. Before that, we learn some parameters. Before that, I request you to subscribe my channels. If you learn something, like my video and comment on the video and share with your friend. For Pelton wheel turbine, U1 equal to U2 is equal to U is equal to pi d n by 60, means U1 and U2 both are same for a Pelton wheel turbine. Second, alpha 1 is 0, beta 1 is 0. Because in this Pelton wheel turbine, the blade is strike in horizontal direction. Okay, so angle of the nozzle is 0 and beta 1 is also 0. In this outlet, the beta 2 at a certain angle, that's why it is derived in a two parts. But in this case, V1 is horizontal. So V1 is directly equal to VW2 because it is a horizontal, no vertical part. No vertical part means VF1 is 0. VF1 is 0, then V1 is equal to VW1. So here we write V1 is equal to VW1. Relative velocity is V1 minus U1 and U1 is equal to U. So instead of U1, we write the U. So this is the equation from this inlet velocity part. Now U and V both are in same directions. For a smooth surface of the bucket, if you assume in an example the bucket is too smooth, at that time relative velocity VR1 and VR2 are equal. But in some case, in example, there is a friction loss is given for the bucket. That means VR1 and VR2 are not same. For that, you need to find out VR2. At that time, we use the equation VR2 is equal to K VR1. Means due to friction, some velocity is lost. And the K is equal to blade friction coefficient. In example, suppose you give the 0.85 blade friction coefficient or 85 blade friction coefficient. So you need to find out relative velocity by using this equation VR2 is equal to KVR1. Now next, how to consider the mass for this Pelton wheel turbine. In a Pelton wheel turbine or any other turbine, that is a series of N, means there is a number of bucket is there, in which volta mass of the water coming from a nozzle strike the bucket, means mass coming out from nozzle is continuously contact with the bucket. So that reasons mass flow rate is in the terms of V1, not in the terms of VR1. So mass is equal to rho A V1 for a Pelton wheel turbine. So mass is equal to rho A V1. Next, we find out the force exerted by jet of water on the bucket in direction of motion. The equation of force we already find out in the case of series of plate in a chapter of impact object, so we are not again derived. So we directly return the equation of Fx, that is rho AV1 is equal to, sorry, Fx is equal to rho AV1 into VW1 plus 1 minus VW2. Now in which case we take the plus, in which case we get the minus, if you want to learn this, then go to the my playlist or in description and watch the video of impact object on a moving cow plate at tangentially supplied. So this is a plus when the alpha 2 is less than 90, and when alpha 2 is greater than 90, then we take this minus, and when the alpha 2 equal to 90, at that time VW2 is 0. So this is the equation of Fx, that A is cross section area pi by 4 d square, d is equal to diameter of jet, rho is density of water, that is taken 1000. Next we find out the work done. work done is equal to force into distance displaced, that is the fx into u. So this is the equation of fx, that is rho a v1 into vw1 plus 1 minus vw2 into multiplied with this u, and we get the work done. Next is work done per unit weight. That is not necessary for deriving this equation, but it is just simply written here. So it is divided by the weight, so weight is equal to rho a v1 into g, and we get this equation. Now next, we find out the kinetic energy of a jet per second. Kinetic energy for a jet is considered as 1 by 2 into m into velocity square. So it is a 1 by 2 m v1 square. What is m? That we already written, that is a rho a v1. So that is a 1 by 2 rho a v1 into v1 square. So it is a 1 by 2 rho a v1 cube. So this is the equation for kinetic energy. Next we find out the hydraulic efficiency. Hydraulic efficiency is equal to work done divided by kinetic energy. So work done, that we already know, that is work done per second, that is a rho a v1 into vw1 plus 1 minus vw2 into u2, that is divided by the kinetic energy, that is 1 by 2 rho a v cube. On that, rho a v1 is cancelled, these two is moving upper part. So it is a 2 into vw1 plus 1 minus vw2 into u2 divided by v1 square. So this v1, here v1 cube, so v1 is divided, then here comes the v1 square. So this is our equation. Now in this equation, we put in the value of vw1 and vw2 from a velocity triangle. Before that, I request you to subscribe my channels, comment on the video, like the video and share with your friend. So here I again draw this velocity line. So in this velocity line, this v1 is equal to vw1, okay, that we already learned. So instance of this vw1, we putting the v1, and the vr1 is equal to v1 minus u is equal to vr2, that we conclude from inlet velocity triangle. Here again I draw to the outlet velocity triangle. So from outlet velocity triangle, we need to define the value of vw2. For that, we apply the equation of cos beta 2. Cos beta 2 is equal to adjacent side. Adjacent side, so we are considered a triangle PQS. So adjacent side is u2 plus vw2 divided by hypotenuse, that is vr2. So it is equation is cos beta 2 equal to u2 plus vw2 divided by vr2. And we need to find out the vw2. So it is a cos beta 2 into vr2 equal to u2 plus vw2. So vw2 is equal to vr2 into cos beta 2 minus u2. Now in this equation, we put the value of vr2. So from the inlet, vr2 is equal to vr1. So here we write down vr1 cos beta 2, instance of u2 we write the u. Now instance of vr1, again we return, that is a v1 minus u. So vw2 is equal to v1 minus u cos beta 2 minus u. Now this value of vw1 and vw2 is putting in this equation, and we get our final equation. So I just shift this thing on the left side. Now putting this value in this equation of hydraulic efficiency. So instance of this vw1, we written v1. Instance of vw2, it is written v1 minus u into cos beta 2 and minus u. Now in the next step, this v1 minus u is written together. So this minus u is come with this v1. So here written v1 minus u. After that, we take the common, that is the v1 minus u is taken common. Then this step is written like this way, 2 into v1 minus u is common. So in bracket, instance of this v1 minus u, it is a 1 plus this going, and is the cos beta 2 bracket over into u divided by v1 square. Now this is our final equations for the hydraulic efficiency. Next we derive maximum efficiency for a Pelton wheel turbine. For finding out maximum efficiency, we need to derive the condition for maximum efficiency. So first we find out condition for maximum efficiency. For that, we need to differentiate this equation with the velocity u. So this equation is differentiated with the u. So the constant parameter, we take the common, that is a 1 plus cos beta 2 upon v1 square is coming the common, because they are not doing the differential. So only we differential, that is a v1 minus u into u square. So here we open the bracket, v1 minus u into u. So it is v1 minus u into u square. So for during, for that, we need to differentiate only by using the simple equation that suppose x raised to n power, then n is come forward into x raised to n minus 1. So in this our case, u is our x and the power is 1. So 1 is come ahead and 1 minus 1, that is a 0. So u is equal to 1. In this case, x is u, power is n is equal to 2. So 2 is coming forward, u raised to 2 minus 1, that is a 1. So it is a 2u. So this differential is written like that, v1 minus 2u is equal to 0. For that, we finally conclude that u is equal to v1 by 2. Now, this is our condition for maximum efficiency. If we achieve this condition, then we are able to achieve a maximum efficiency. Now, we are putting this value of u is equal to v1 by 2 into equation of hydraulic efficiency. So here I again written the equation of hydraulic efficiency. Now this efficiency is known as maximum. So here we need to write down max. Now instance of u, we are putting v1 by 2 in this equation of hydraulic efficiency. So all the u is replaced by v1 by 2. So here u, it is replaced by v1 by 2. This u is also replaced by v1 by 2. Now we simplified it. After simplifications, we get the final equation, that is 1 plus cos beta by 2. So this is the final equations for a maximum efficiency. And from this equation, we conclude that maximum efficiency for a Pelton wheel turbine is only depend on a blade angle beta 2, not depend on the any velocity of a Pelton wheel turbine. It is only depend on the beta 2. Thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like my video, subscribe my channels and share with your friends.